Hello students, welcome to the next video on the topic ANOVA. In this video we will see what is the Latin scale design and how it can be resolved the problem of our day-to-day life using the ANOVA model. So myself Harish Garg. So far we have studied the four lectures on the ANOVA. That is, the first lecture was on the one-way ANOVA, second lecture was on the procedure of the one-way ANOVA where we have solved the several examples and then construct the ANOVA table, while the third and fourth are similar for the two-way ANOVAs. Now just quickly recall that what we have studied in the one-way and the two-ways. In the one-way ANOVA we have the one factor, that is called as the treatment, and how many treatments are there, so we consider that k treatments are there. So in general it will be like this way, so that is 1, 2 up to so on. And here since there is only one factor, so this is called as the treatment. So what is the degree of the freedom of the treatment is k minus 1. Total number of the observations are n, so and then so on. While for the two-way ANOVA there are the two factors, one is the row, second is the column, and we have represented like this way, one is the row, second is the column, also called as the treatment and the blocks. One feature in the two-way ANOVA we have studied is that the number of elements in each row must be same. If I say this is the n1 number of elements, then it must contain n1 number of the elements. Similarly, third row must contain the n1 number of elements. Now in this presentation we will try to see what's the difference between the Latin scale design as compared to the one way and the two way, and how we can solve the problem. So first of all, what is the Latin scale? So it is a, since it is a scale, so we must see that it's a 3 × 3, it's a 4 × 4, it's a 5 × 5. So these scales are called as the Latin scale design. So a simple scale is called as a scale. Why we call it as a Latin? And Latin, the feature of Latin is that you can see that in the first row there is only one A present, while in the first column there is only one A present. Either you can see in the 4 × 4 or either 5 × 5 and so on. Look at it, in the first row the only A present or any one symbol. Similarly for the column. So with this feature is called as the Latin scale. So it must be the scale array. That is, always be a n cross n, 3 × 3, 4 × 4 with the letter A, B, C, D. Okay, such that each object appears once and only once in each row. That is the most important thing. Look at that. This, for example, if I just consider 4 ABCDs are there, so say that is the Latin scale of the array 4. So I can consider ABCD, BCD, and look at that in each row, and in this, say for example, in the first row and in the first column, you can see that all A is present only one times, B is present only for the one time cell. Okay, this is not be a unique representation. You can also see that this is the second representation of the 4 × 4. You can, instead of starting with the A, you can start with the C, while again you can see that in the each row there is a one C, while in the one C in the one column. Similarly, you can see there is a one B in this column and one B in this column, in this row. So such type of the representation is called as the Latin scale. Look at that, if I call as this A, B, C, D, then this is B, A, C, D, then B, C, D, A, and C, D, A, B. So this is not the Latin scale, because in this column, look at that, in this column there are the two B. Okay. Now, what is the general representation of this is that, look at that, I just considered there are the four drivers are there, A, B, C, D, and four core. Definitely it will be the square matrix always. So what will D is, so what we'll see is that this is firstly is of the square matrix. Okay, and what is the representation of this? Here look at that, there are, instead of the two factors in the two-way ANOVA, one in the one-way ANOVA, here we have considered the three factors. Look at that, one is the driver ABCD, second is the car, and what is the ABCD represent? They are the petrols. Okay, for example, what is actually happening in the Latin scale design is, look at the first row. First, what is the first row represents? That we have to fix the driver A, and we have assigned the four different cars and the four different types of the petrols. What is the meaning of that? In this assignment, in this assignment we have fixed the effect of the driver A and analyze the effect of the car and the petrols onto the driver A. Similarly, look at that, this we have fixed the driver C and randomly assign the petrols C, D, A, B on the different weeks are there. Similarly, if you look at the first column, what will happen in the first column is we have fixed the first car and that car is assigned to the four drivers with respect to the four different kind of the petrols A, B, C, D. Similarly for the third, second and so on. And then we will check whether there is any significant difference between the A, B, C, D, that is driver or the car or the petrols are there. So this is the general representation of this LCD, that is a Latin scale design. So remember we have all talking about the three-way instead of the two-way and the one-way are there. So look at that, what is the meaning of this A represent? Driver A will use the petrol A in the car 1. What is the meaning of this is the driver B, this is the driver B, will use the petrol C in the car 2. And similarly for the other meanings are there. And look at that, each row must have the 1A, 1B and C are there. So what is the difference between the two-way ANOVA and this Latin scale designer? So remember that in the two-way ANOVA we have this number of the rows and this is the number of the columns are there. And we know that in each row the number of the elements must be equal in the two-way ANOVA, while in the column wise also be. Okay, so that is whole the experiment is divided into the homogeneous blocks. Homogeneous we call as because the number of the elements in each row are same, while the number of elements in each columns are same. But it is quite obvious that the number of rows may or may not be equal to the number of the columns. While in this Latin scale design, we have the equal number of the rows and equal number of the columns. It means whenever we are talking about this, so if here we have the four rows, then it means it has the four columns. While in the two-way ANOVA, it may happen that there are the five rows and the four columns are there. So in the Latin scale design, the rows and the column must be equal and must be equal to the treatments. What is the treatment? Here we, if we write here A, B, C and so on, these are called as the treatments. So in the LSD, we have the three factors. One is the row, second is the column and third is the treatment. And treatment is always be denoted as A, B, C, D and so on. And one main feature is that the number of the treatments, number of the rows and the number of the columns must be equal and equal to this one particular number. So if this condition holds, then it is only for the LSD. While if the number of the rows is equal to number of the columns, but is not equal to the number of the treatments, then this will never be a LSD. So the row column treatment, so since it is a number of the n elements in the each row, so it means this is my n cross n observation. So the row column treatments are represented by the cells in the n cross n array. So this, and the values assigned in between them, that is 1 to 1, here is called as the A, this is called as the Latin scale arrangement. Look at that, this line, what is this? This is a n cross n, that is a 4, this is a 4 cross 4, and this A, B, C, D are my representing the treatments, that is a petrols. So here petrol is my treatments. So what is the general model of the Latin scale design? This Xij, remember that whenever we are trying to calculate the SS total, either in the one way or the two way ANOVA, we have used this observation. So since I and J are the two factors, now here there are the three ways. So I, J and K both are there. Mu is called as the grand mean. Okay, tau is called as the effect of the kth treatment. Rho I just called as the for the row wise. Gamma is for the column wise. Epsilon is called as the error in between them. So what we'll have to do is in the Latin scale design is look at that. There is a between the row, between the columns, between the treatments and rest are similar. So if we consider only one, that is called as the one-way ANOVA. If we consider between the row and the column both, then it's a two-way ANOVA. If we consider between the row, columns and the treatment, then it is called as the Latin scale design. And the way of calculating this is remain the same. Look at that, how to calculate the sum of the squares. If you remember the one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, we always use this. Summation of Ti square divided by Ni minus E. What is the Ti is? What is Ti is my total of, here is we call this row, so total of the ith row, the total of the rows. Here the column is denoted by Tj, so this is the total of the columns. And since here is a one more term, that is a treatment, so treatment is denoted with the A, B, C, D. So what we'll do is, this is Tk. What is a Tk? Is total of the A, total of B, total of C, and D are there. And rest are similar. So C is G square. So that is all procedure are remain same as of the one way and the two way. So how to formulate the problem and how to solve them? So look at that. First of all, look at what is the construct the ANOVA table for this information. So check whether this is a lattice scale design or not. So you have to check that two things. One is that there must be a three factors are there. Okay. Second is that the number of the rows must be equal to the number of the columns. Okay. And it must be equal to the number of the treatments. So that is the ABCD. So how many ABCDs are there? Look at that in this table. There are A, B, C, and D. So it means must be 4. So number of the row must be 4. That's true. Number of the columns are 4. That's true. So how to for? What is the meaning of this 18? What is the meaning of this A and so on? So how to formulate? Look at the graphical representation. So suppose that the different brands of the petrols are to be compared with respect to the mileage per liter. So what is the meaning of that? You have to compare the petrol with respect to the mileage. So it means this 18 is something look like the mileage. Mileage means this when the driver A use the petrol capital A in the car 1, then it gives the mileage is 18, okay, per liter. So what is the important factor is there are the two variations are there. One is with respect to the car and second is with respect to the driver. So I just represent car in terms of the columns and the driver in terms of the row. So look at that, this drivers in terms of the row, columns in terms of their column, cars in terms of the column. So what is the ABCD represents that? So look at that, these two factors, that is a car and the drivers, are depending upon the petrols. So it means my A, B, C, D are my representing my petrol. So look at that. So we have the three factors. One is a car, second is a driver, and third is the petrol brand. Okay, either the Reliance or HP or Indian and so on. So what we have the four types of the car represented as ABC 1, 2, 3, 4. Four drivers are there, ABCD, and the four brands, capital ABCD. So these 16 observations, 4 cross 4 is the 16 observations, are recorded in terms of their treatment combinations, that is A, B, C, D, and so on. Look at that, each row and each column has only one petrol. And what is that? So this 18 represents for their mileage B. Okay. Similarly, this 22, what is the meaning of this 22 is, this is gives the mileage per liter when the driver D uses the petrol. What is the petrol is D in the car 1. Okay. Similarly for the other observations. So what will we do? So how you solve this? How to construct the ANOVA table B? So look at that. What we do is you can find the total row wise. Okay. Then total column wise. And then you have to find the value of the C. That is nothing but the G square by N, and then find their sum of the squares between the row, column, and so on. But look at that very carefully. The observation, that is 18, 21, 25s, are quite lengthy. Okay, so once you are trying to calculate their SS of the total, so what will happen is that this is XIJ square minus E, so that is 18 square, 21 square, 20. So calculation is quite lengthy. So how to reduce the calculation is you can either add or you can subtract a single number from each of the entries. You can try to solve itself also, that is 18 plus 21 plus 25 plus this and so on. The result will remain the same. So I can try to solve it by a simplification. I can subtract any number in between them. So look at this, what is the smallest number? Smallest number is my, so what is that, 10. And what is the largest number I can see in that is 25. So choose any number in between them. Okay, so I can choose a number 19 and subtract from the each entry. So what is that? This is 18 minus 19 minus 1, 21 minus 19 is plus 2, 25 minus 9 is plus 6, and so on. Now since the numbers are obtained minus 1, 2 are less as compared to this, and the calculation is quite simple as compared to this one. So what we'll be do is now rest will remain the same. So you can find the sum of this. So what will be the sum is minus 1 plus 2 plus 6 minus 8. So that will be my minus of 1. Look at this. This red color is for the total is for the red. Blue is representing for the column wise. So similarly for here, what will be happen is this is minus of 8. Minus 4 plus 1 plus 4 plus 5. That is plus 6. 3 plus 2 minus 9 minus 2. That is minus of 6. So what is that total is my minus of 9. This is nothing but my G. Either you can sum on this side. On this side the total will remain the same. Okay. So total is remain the same. Look at that. 1 minus 2 minus 3 5. So this is the between the row. Between the columns. And between the treatment. So this is the total of the treatment. So what is the meaning of this? So how many treatments are there? That is how many petrols. So treatment means there are my petrols. So that is petrols is my ABCD. So what is that? What is the A? So the sum of A is my 5. How I calculate? What is the A is minus 5. What is the A in the second is 0. A is third is 4. A in the fourth one is 2. So what is the sum is minus 1 plus 4 plus 0 plus 2. So it will be my 5. Similarly, what is the sum of the B? So what is the B is my 2, 3, 5, 5 plus 5, 10, and 10 minus 9, 1. So look at that, this is 1. And similarly for the others. Okay. And you can check your answer at any step in the ANOVA table. Either you can find the G through this, it will be minus 9. You can find the G through this, it will again be minus 9. And if you find the G through this, again G will be minus 9. And it must be same. Either you can use the row wise, column wise, or the treatment wise. Okay, the same rule is applicable also in the two-way ANOVA. We have seen that. So what is the meaning of this is now you can find the correction factor C, that is a G square by N. G is my 9 minus 9. What is the total number is 16. And the rest procedure are remain the same. Okay. So now G is here. So what is the SS between the driver? That is a driver is row wise. So minus 1 square. Look at that. This is minus 1 square divided by how many elements are there in the row? 4. Plus minus 8 square divided by 4 plus 6 square minus 6 square. So it will comes to be here. SS column. So here is the column wise. 1 square divided by 4. Minus 2 square divided by 4. Minus 3 square divided by 4. Minus 5 divided by 4. Minus of C. What is the treatment? So that is the A. What is the sum of the A is 5. So that is a 5 square divided by how many A's are there? 4. Plus 1 square divided by 4. Minus 7 square divided by 4 and so on. You will get this. And the final is total is minus 1 square plus 2 square plus 6 square plus minus 8 square and so on up to here minus of C. So you will see that the procedure of ANOVA, either a one way, two way, three ways remain the same. That is remain same total and so on. So what is the next step is you can substitute here. This is the values. What is the degree of freedom of the row? How many rows are there? These are 4. So the degree of freedom is my 3. What is the column is 3. Treatment, there are 4 ABCDs. So 3, what is the total number of the observations? How many total elements are there? 16. So it will be my 15. So what is that number is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus this is equal to 16. So that number is my 6. Now how you find this number is this plus this plus this plus this must be equal to 329. So you can find easily this number. So this number is quite here. And the rest is usual calculation. What is the MSS is DFSS divided by DF. This divided by this, you will get this number. This divided by this, you will get this number. This divided by this, you will get this number. This divided by this, you will get this number. What is the ratio is? That is row divided by error. So what is the row is? This number. Okay, divided by error, you will get this number. What is the column is? That is the column divided by error. Always divided with the error. So column is this number divided by this number. So you will get this. What is that treatment? So this is my treatment divided by error. So and look at that. What is that degree of freedom for this is row. Row is my 3. Column is my 6. What is for here? This is again 3, 6 and again 3 is 6. Now since there are the three factors are there, so you have to define the three ANOVAs, 3 H0, this and this. Okay, so this value is come out to be f of 3,6, you can see from the table. Okay, and this is for the rows, this is for the column, and this for the treatment. And since all the values are starting from the 0 point something, so this value is my 0. Okay, so always be a here, so that is accepted H0. It means there is no significant difference between them, or you can say there is no such evidence are produced to discard this state. Okay, quickly move on the problem number 2. A courier company is interested in deciding the 5 brands A, B, C, D. So it means if it is a Latin square, then it's a 5x5 for its next purchase of the cars. So one factor is the car with the help of the brands. The brands are all comparable in the purchase price. So one another factor is called as the price. So how many things are there? One is the price, car and the brands. The company wants to carry out a study that will enable to compare the brands with respect to their cost. So how many factors are there? For this purpose, they select the 5 drivers. First of all, they select the 5 drivers. And in addition, they will study carry about the 5 weeks. So instead of the cars, they will study on their weeks. And each week, a driver is assigned a car using the randomization and the Latin square design. So what is the meaning of this? This means that driver 1 assign a car. Driver 1 assign a car A in the first week. Look at that. This meaning is that driver 2 assign a car A on the week 3rd. Okay. So what is, if I represent here as say 41, so what is the meaning of this 41 is that is comparable with your operating cost. So the here analyze, so what is this the problem? So this is the based on the above formulation, you can analyze whether there is any effect of the brand. So what are the brand? Brands are my A, B, C, D. The average cost per miles is recorded here. So what is the meaning of this is? This is the average cost of the driver 1 when A brand is used in the first week and similarly so on. So since there are the 5x5, you can find the total here. Since the observations are very large, so you can subtract any number from it based on your choice. Look at the largest number, look at the smallest number. Okay, so you can subtract say 45 from the each number. 45.2 is choice on you. So once you subtract, you can find the total row, column and so on. And then you can try yourself. So I hope this small presentation will help you to understand the Latin square design. Remember that whenever you are trying to move on the either on the one way or the two way or the Latin square design, always remember whenever you are trying to compute the ANOVA table, always this rule: SS total is nothing but Xij square minus C, and the row, column and the factors are based on this. Okay. And whenever you are trying to solve this, you can subtract a smallest number or the largest number or add them based on your choice so that your calculation will be easy. Okay. So we can add, we can subtract only for our sake of the convenience. Otherwise, there is no need of them. So once you construct the ANOVA table and this table after this subtracting any number, and when you add any number, so all the tables, this is table number A and this is table number B, and say this is table number C. This is a table obtained by the original observation, this is a table obtained by subtracting some observations, and this is table obtained, ANOVA table obtained after adding some. And you will see that all the tables, that is whether the all the entries mentioned in the table A, table B and the table C are exactly the same. If it is not same, then your error will be there. So I hope you can enjoy this session also. So be practice more based on the Latin square design and the one way and the two way. Thank you very much. If you feel any doubts, still ask me. You can do comments. I will respond to you as soon as possible. Thank you very much.